to talk to you about today is the fact that our thoughts, our feelings, and our emotions actually originate as chemicals in our brain. And when our chemistry is off, it really changes the function of our brain, from how we process information, what we focus on, how we communicate, but it especially affects our levels of confidence. Now, when you think about who are some of the most consistently confident people out there, it's professional athletes, because they're super intentional about optimizing their chemistry by getting warmed up through movement and exercise, through food, through visualization and goal setting and beliefs. We have to optimize our chemistry before we can optimize our intellect and our potential. And so I'm starting a series called The Five Chemicals of Confidence. And I'm going to be talking about what these chemicals are and how you can increase or decrease them depending on your needs and the situation. So the first one that we're going to be talking about today is serotonin. And I really like to call this one the confidence molecule. So, you know, when you're totally just on fire, you're in the zone, you're on target, you're on the game, and you are just like all systems are firing and you're like, oh my God, this is awesome. That is serotonin at work. And in fact, a lot of the prescription medications for anxiety and depression, things like Zoloft, Paxil, Wellbutrin, are so effective because they're increasing serotonin in the brain. So when serotonin levels are higher, we obviously feel more confident, but we're also more socially extroverted. We are sleeping better. We are less anxious and less depressed. We have a more balanced mood. We feel pretty darn good when serotonin is high. So, how do we get more serotonin? How do we change our chemistry? There's a handful of ways, but I just want to share three of those with you today. So, the first one is exercise. Shocker, Jenny's prescribing exercise. But what exercise does is it actually increases how much serotonin our brain produces and releases. And multiple research studies have shown that exercise is at least, if not more, effective than prescription medications for anxiety and depression. Now, the good news here is that you do not have to be exercising for hours at a time. Studies have shown that even 5 minutes of exercise produces serotonin and can really make us feel more confident and enhance our mood. The second thing that we can do to improve serotonin is through diet. So our brain produces a lot of our serotonin, but it's also made by our guts and our intestinal system. So confidence really does take guts, but it takes the right kind of guts. So there are just some really simple things. You don't have to do a complete dietary overhaul. It's literally just as simple as eating a little bit less of some things and eating a little bit more of some other things. So foods that we want to just be trying to eat more of: fresh fruits, fresh vegetables, whole grains. Fermented foods are great for your gut bacteria. Things like yogurt, sauerkraut, kombucha, kefir, which is a fermented milk. You could also take probiotics. And then just trying to eat less saturated fat, less fast food, and less saturated, less processed food. So less saturated fat, less fast food, and less processed food. So all of those things are good for a healthy gut microbiome so that you can produce lots of serotonin. The last thing that I want to share with you, strategy, is through reflection. So just literally taking a minute or two to reflect on a past accomplishment or achievement or victory can sort of like turn you into this chemist sorcerer, where you can actually just conjure the production of serotonin in your brain. So simple things like creating a gratitude list of maybe three things that you're really grateful for, or when you're heading into a stressful situation, just reflect on another instance where you successfully got through it or even just survived it, can start producing serotonin in the brain. So that's going to be it for serotonin. So next time we're going to talk about this guy. which is GABA, and this produces a lot of the same things that Valium and Xanax produce. So you might want to tune in for this one. So next time, that's what we're going to cover.